Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us on Bobcat Update. I'm James Smith.
And I'm Hunter Cortez. Coming up, a hacker has targeted the city of San Marcos' website, and there's a tie to Texas State. But we begin with the city mourning the loss of a musical legend. Monday marked the anniversary of Texas Independence Day, and San Marcos Cheatham Street Warehouse hosted a big live music celebration to commemorate the event. But it became something more as friends and family of Kent Finley paid tribute to the man who ran Cheatham Street Warehouse for more than 40 years. Finley died early Monday morning.
Finley was a local legend known for nurturing hundreds of musicians and songwriters for four decades. He was a songwriter himself and enjoyed sharing his work on many Wednesday nights in a songwriter circle. The showcase would often have as many as 20 musicians perform their songs and receive pointers for making them better. Many of those who were at the bar Monday night wore red bandanas as a small tribute to Finley. Back in the mid-1970s, Finley helped a little-known artist named George Strait get his start. Strait played his first show at Cheatham Street Warehouse in 1975. Finley was 77. The Supreme Court appears to be divided on the future of the Affordable Care Act, also known as Obamacare. The nation's highest court is hearing a case that could eliminate tax credits used by millions of Americans to pay for their insurance premiums. The court's four liberal justices appeared to believe the law justifies the use of tax credits, while two of the conservative justices indicted it doesn't read that way. Chief Justice John Roberts and Justice Anthony Kennedy appear to be the swing votes on the court. A ruling on the matter of that is expected in June.
Colds and the flu can spread quickly on a college campus. Those who become ill can be treated at the Student Health Center. Haley Watson has more in this Bobcat update.
Most students try to take precautions to stay healthy. In each building on campus, they can find hand sanitizers and sanitation wipes to help reduce the spread of germs. But if all else fails, a trip to the Student Health Center may be necessary. And it's a good idea to have insurance.
I think I saw an email out on it, but to be honest, I haven't read in the details. I carry my own insurance through where I work.
Even though the health center is offering this option, many students don't know about it.
One of my coworkers mentioned it, saying something about they're providing insurance for like students who don't have insurance, so your copay is only like 20 instead of like super more expensive.
We're probably not doing near as good a job as we should be about getting the word out. Right now we pretty much advertise this through students that are calling to ask us or having it on our webpage.
Some students may still be under their parents' insurance plan since the cutoff age is now 26. Those who need their own policy can find information at the Student Health Center's website. The deadline is Friday. For Bobcat Update, I'm Haley Watson.
Students might be surprised to know that Texas State officials have placed a ban on electronic cigarettes. Texas State has been a tobacco-free campus since August of 2011, and the ban will now include e-cigs because the FDA defines them as a tobacco and nicotine delivery device. Police officers say catching someone breaking the rule will be difficult, but they will follow up on any reports of e-cig usage on campus.
Music lovers at Texas State have two new exhibits at the Whitliff Collections to be singing about. Nick Cassiano has more with this Bobcat update.
The Whitliff Collections at Texas State's Alkick Library have been the home to multiple exhibits throughout the years. From the Faces of Texas to the Lonesome Dove Collection, the Whitliff Collections offer a variety of exhibits for students, faculty, and anyone interested in history.
Well, the Whitliff Collection concentrates with Southwestern photography and Southwestern writers collection, and also we have archives, which has many different Texans. We have like Willie Nelson stuff, we have King of the Hill, and also we have our pandemic collection, which is a Lonesome Dove.
The Whitliff's newest edition is called Homegrown, featuring hand-drawn music posters from Austin's music scene.
So the Homegrown exhibition that's on view right now at the Whitliff Collections is our premier exhibition of music posters that were created in the late 1960s through the early 1980s.
Keeping with the homegrown theme is another Whitliff exhibit called Armadillo Rising. It features artifacts from the 1970s, including items like Willie Nelson's blue jeans and shoes, the guitar he played at Austin City Limits, and even some spent marijuana joints. The exhibit Homegrown and Armadillo Rising will run until July 3rd. For more information on events hosted by the Whitliff Collections, you can visit the Whitliff Collections website. For Bobcat Update, I'm Nick Cassiano.
The official mobile app of South by Southwest 2015 is now available in both the iOS and Android app stores. South by Southwest Go, the official name of the application, will rely heavily on Apple's iBeacon technology, which will connect more than 1,000 beacons placed across Austin. The beacons will be placed in local venues and will allow attendees to check in and connect with other users. Along with check-ins, the app will allow festival goers to access a visual guide to a lineup of speakers, performers, and events.
Spring break is coming up at Texas State, and the university is offering some options for those who are unsure of their plans. Ellis English has more on this Bobcat update.
This year's spring break is from March 16th through the 19th, and what better way to spend the week off than by traveling? This year, Texas State is hosting 4 trips for any student who wants to go and explore nature.
Student Volunteer Connection has been doing Bobcat Break for a while now. This year, we're taking 4 trips, which I think is the biggest that we've ever been able to do, to Killeen, Arkansas, New Orleans, and Austin.
For those who want to attend, spots are filling up fast, and the best way to sign up is by going to the Campus Activities and Student Organizations desk, located on the 4th floor of LBJ. For those students who aren't able to leave campus, some dorms will remain open. However, the dining halls won't.
Students that are living on campus, they have to leave for spring break. So nobody's actually residing here except for a handful of, say, people who don't have a place to go for spring break or international students.
And of course, Sewell Park is always a great place to spend time, whether you want to rent kayaks or work on your tan. For Bobcat Update, I'm Ellis English.
Still to come, a hacker has threatened the city of San Marcos' website, and there's a Texas State tie to the story. The details are next.
And a blast of cold weather, along with maybe some ice and sleet, is on the way for tonight. See how you can be among the first to find out if classes are canceled tomorrow when Bobcat Update returns.
Bobcat Bobbies are here for you when you need them most. If you feel threatened or are temporarily disabled, call a Bobcat Bobby at 512-245-SAFE.
The official website of the City of San Marcos is still down following security threats received overnight Tuesday. A hacker group under the name of Bitcoin Baron apparently targeted the city's website in retaliation for a Texas State student who says a police officer assaulted her in 2013. The group claims it is seeking justice for the student despite the fact that the officer involved in the incident was fired. Vision Internet, the city's website provider, is working to reinforce security and get the site back up and running, but is still continuing to block the traffic to the site until further notice.
Life as a freshman can be intimidating, but it doesn't have to be. Texas State has resources available to help freshmen overcome their anxieties about what's ahead. Erin Pollock has more in this Bobcat update.
Texas State offers many services to freshmen, including personalized academic and career exploration, or PACE. Claudia Gasponi, an employee of the Undergraduate Academic Center, says freshmen often don't know where to go for advice.
The university seminar program, which has the common reading book and the university seminar classes, and all of those resources are like available to the freshmen, but they just don't know to use them. They don't know that they're all here.
These services are designed to help freshmen explore their personal interests, academic plans, and work life. Michelle Bond, a senior administration assistant, says there are steps students can take if they are unsure.
First thing I would do if I was unsure, I would probably want to sign up on the PACE Mentoring website and get an appointment with a mentor, and that's online on PACE Mentoring.
The PACE Center is located in the Undergraduate Academic Center, and the PACE Max Center is on the second floor of Commons Dining Hall. Freshman Kayla Henneke says she has been to the PACE Center for advice.
I definitely use my advisor a lot more than the others.
For more information, visit the PACE Center. For Bobcat Update, I'm Erin Pollock.
The rules governing 529 college savings plans could be changing. House lawmakers passed legislation that would change provisions in the plan. The first will allow families to purchase computers using their 529 money. Those computers must be used for schooling purposes only. The second provision will allow plan holders to contribute money tax-free to the plan, only if the money is refunded from the school. The bill comes after the White House declined to move forward on a proposal to cut back on tax benefits of 529S. Texas employees looking for minimum wage earn $7.25 an hour. And as Tyler Stevenson tells us in this Bobcat update, students who earn that amount often struggle to make ends meet.
According to Texas State's financial aid website, the cost of attending the university full-time can range between $18,000 and $32,000. Many students are overwhelmed trying to budget college expenses on a minimum wage budget.
Like the gas to get to work, the food while you're at work, and that's just the living while you're currently working. So it's almost like the money that you're making is enough to just survive almost like at work.
To make up for the lack of income, some students take out loans. But the thought of being in debt after graduation scares some students.
In a very competitive field, and like I do like wake up in the morning thinking, is it worth it?
Last week, when Walmart CEO Doug McMillon announced the company is raising its minimum wage salary to $9 an hour, it sparked a debate about whether all businesses should raise their minimum wage.
It will help bring people out of poverty, at least to some extent. Which is good for them and also good for the economy.
However, there can be a downside to it.
And that will raise prices because employers will want to continue to make the kind of profit that they're making. And then that will be, so there won't be as many jobs available.
While Bouzard says she thinks government will eventually raise the minimum wage, she doubts the increase will be enough to cover the majority of student bills. For Bobcat Update, I'm Tyler Stevenson.
The National Weather Service has issued a winter storm warning for Hays County. The warning is in effect from midnight tonight to noon tomorrow. Freezing rain and sleet is expected. To know if classes will be canceled, sign up for the Texas State Alert System. This emergency notification system sends text directly to your phone at no charge. To sign up for these messages, go to emergencyinfo.txstate.edu and log in with your NetID and password.
Judge Judy will stay in session after extending her contract with CBS through 2020. The show is in its 19th season and has been rated number one in daytime TV for the past 5 years. At 72 years old, she is the highest paid personality on TV, making $47 million a year, but it is unknown if she will be getting a raise in the new contract.
A man from Long Island, New York, suffered third-degree burns after his iPhone exploded in his pocket. Eric Johnson heard a popping noise when bending over to get his keys before his pants caught on fire. The phone was so hot it stuck to his skin, and now Johnson has to wear bandages around his thigh where he was burned. Photos of the phone show the screen is melted and is still glued to the phone case. One possible cause of the explosion is using the wrong charger. But Johnson said that wasn't the case and plans on suing Apple. Wow, that makes me second guess, you know, putting my phone in my pocket.
Makes me second guess getting an Apple phone. I guess I'll go to an Android, huh?
That's true.
Well, that'll do it with this Bobcat Update today. Thanks for scheduling a part of your afternoon with us.
Bobcat Update returns tomorrow at 4:30. Stay warm and have a great night.